the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say,
I want to thank everybody, because this was a rough, rough day for all of us. You know that. And I have to start by saying hello, Illinois. Special place, special people, great people. Hello, Illinois. And I'll tell you what, with this crowd, Mike Bost is going to win big. He has to win big. He has to win big. But it's great to be back in the heartland with thousands of hardworking American patriots as we work to reelect a great man. And actually, to be honest, we have three great congressmen here with us today. And we're going to get every one of them in office. And I want to just thank you. But I do specifically, he's been so great on steel and getting your jobs back. I felt I owed it to a congressman to come up today, Mike Bost. Thank you. He's been fighting for you and very hard. Before going any further, I want to address the horrible shooting that took place earlier today. The hearts of all Americans are filled with grief following the monstrous killing of Jewish Americans at the Tree of Life Synagogue in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. You've all seen it. You've been watching it. It's horrible. The suspect is in custody. The federal authorities are on the scene and leading an aggressive federal investigation. State and local law enforcement has been incredible. This evil anti-Semitic attack is an assault on all of us. It's an assault on humanity. It will require all of us working together to extract the hateful poison of anti-Semitism from our world. This was an anti-Semitic attack at its worst. The scourge of anti-Semitism cannot be ignored, cannot be tolerated, and it cannot be allowed to continue. We can't allow it to continue. It must be confronted and condemned everywhere it rears its very ugly head. We must stand with our Jewish brothers and sisters to defeat anti-Semitism and vanquish the forces of hate. That's what it is. Through the centuries, the Jews have endured terrible persecution, and you know that. We've all read it. We've studied it. They've gone through a lot. And those seeking their destruction, we will seek their destruction. Now, when you have crimes like this, whether it's this one or another one on another group, we have to bring back the death penalty. They have to pay the ultimate price. They have to pay the ultimate price. They can't do this. They can't do this to our country. We must draw a line in the sand and say very strongly, never again. Tonight, everyone in this arena and every citizen across the land sends our prayers to the victims and their families. We all do. We also send our gratitude to the law enforcement officers who were incredible and who risked their lives and sustained very, very serious injuries during this horrible attack. We salute the heroes of American law enforcement. We always do. We always do. We know how much we appreciate them, and yet they're underappreciated. They have done such an incredible job for so long, and it's a tough job. We see it now. We see it now, maybe like we've never seen it before. And this is the time to renew the bonds of love and loyalty that hold us all together as Americans. These bonds have always sustained our nation in its hour of need. You know that. Everybody here knows that. And they are always more powerful than the forces of hatred and division, anger and evil. In America, we love our families, we love our neighbors, and we protect our community. We trust in God. We protect the freedom of worship. And we believe in the power of prayer. We defend our Constitution. We defend our heritage. And we rally around our great American flag like nobody does. All of us here tonight are united by these same American values, and we are all fighting to defend these values in this election. This is a very, very important election. This could be, and I've said it, and I've heard it, and they have spoken it many times, this is our most important midterm election perhaps ever. Because we've made so much progress. This is steel country and lots of other country. We have made so much progress, we don't want to give up that progress. We can't allow that to happen. Under Republican leadership, America is booming like never before because we are finally putting America first. And because we put America first, I had a big decision to make. I just spoke to the future farmers of America in Indianapolis. And with what happened early today, that horrible, horrible attack in Pittsburgh, I was saying maybe I should cancel both this and that. And then I said to myself, I remember Dick Grasso, a friend of mine, great guy. He headed up the New York Stock Exchange on September 11th, and the New York Stock Exchange was open the following day. He said, and what they had to do to open it, you wouldn't believe. We won't even talk to you about it. But he got that exchange open. We can't make these sick, demented, evil people important. And when we... And when we start changing around our lives and changing around our schedules and telling thousands and thousands, look at this group of people and outside. And I hate to say it, but outside you have a group that's almost as big or just as big trying to get in. So you got the better location. But they have a better movie screen, okay? And they're great. I see them right there. A lot of people and great people. But we can't allow people like this to become important. And when we change all of our lives in order to accommodate them, it's not acceptable. So I thought of it for a little while. And the press said, are you going to cancel these two events? And frankly, the Future Farmers, I could have done that one. But this is a rally for Mike Bost, and frankly, this one maybe I could have, except I don't want to change our life for somebody that's sick and evil, and I don't think we ever should. I don't think we ever should. Remember the New York Stock Exchange. Remember the teams, the Yankees, George Steinbrenner. He said, we got to play. Even if nobody comes, if nobody shows up, we got to play. And I remember that George was a tough man. He was a friend of mine, but he was a good man. And he said, we got to play. And they all played. Now, thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. And I love the people up here also, and I didn't want to have any excuse. I could have had a little bit of an excuse. There was no excuses. We have our lives, we have our schedules, and nobody's going to change it, okay? So we're here. So let's have a good time. And if you don't mind, I'm going to tone it down just a little bit. Is that okay? No. you're from Illinois. I had a feeling you might say that. I know you well. I had a feeling you might say that. But I do, I really appreciate it, and you are amazing people, and we wouldn't miss this. We wouldn't miss this. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Great people. You're great people. You built America. You built America. The unemployment rate just fell to the lowest level in more than 50 years. We predict. More Americans are working today than at any point in the history of our country. Think of that. And I don't want to be rude, but your steel industry was dead as a doornail, and now it's a hot industry again. A hot industry. They can dump if they want, but they're going to pay a big price, and that's what happened. And U.S. Steel is bringing back many plants, you know that, and they're opening up some new ones. And Nucor, you see what they're doing. They're building brand-new, beautiful plants, and I saw plans of one of them. They're so proud of them. You didn't think you'd see that day when they're starting to build the new steel plants. And the steel workers, I said to a couple of them, big, strong guys that came up to me, one of them said, thank you, sir, for saving our country. And he was crying. And I'm telling you, he was crying. I don't think this guy.